still surrounds you here today. The light of God beside you, above, beneath, inside you, the light that shines to guide you home to the loving hand of God.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. In the waters of baptism, Bill died with Christ and rose with him to new life. May he now share with him eternal glory.
Please join in singing number 383, Here I Am, Lord.
I, the Lord of sea and sky, I have heard my people cry, all who dwell in dark and sin, my hand will save. I who made the stars of night, I will make their darkness bright. Who will bear my light to them? Whom shall I send? Here I am, Lord. Is it I, Lord? I have heard you calling in the night. I will go, Lord, if you lead me. I will hold your people in my heart.
Let us pray. Eternal God, you made the union of man and woman a sign of the bond between Christ and the Church. Grant peace and mercy to Bill, who was united in love with his wife, Jeanette. May the care and devotion of Bill's life on earth find a lasting reward in heaven. Look kindly on Jeanette and her family, as now they turn to your compassion and love. Strengthen their faith and lighten their loss. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Would you please be seated? For our first reading from Scripture, we ask the Honorable Edward Harrington, Bill's father, to present it to us.
Reading from the book of Eschylocides. For everything there is a season and a time for every matter under heaven. A time to be born and a time to die, a time to plant, and a time to pick what is planted, a time to kill, and a time to heal, a time to weep, and a time to laugh, a time to mourn, and a time to dance, a time to seek, and a time to lose, a time to tear, and a time to sow, a time to keep silence, and a time to speak, a time to love, and a time to hate, a time for war, and a time for peace.
Please join in our responsorial psalm found at number 428, To You, O Lord. My heart to you, O Lord. I lift my soul to you, O Lord. I lift up my trust in you. I will not be ashamed, for I know that you, O Lord, are near. To you, O Lord, I lift my soul to you, O Lord. I lift up my
For our second reading from Scripture, we ask Bill's daughter, Jackie, to present it to us.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Hope does not disappoint, because the love of God has been poured into our hearts through the Holy Spirit that has been given to us. For Christ, while we were still helpless, yet died at the appointed time for the ungodly. Indeed, only with difficulty does one die for a just person, though perhaps for a good person, one might even find courage to die. But God proves his love for us in that while we were still sinners, Christ died for us. How much more then, since we are now justified by his blood, will we be saved through him from the wrath? Indeed, if, while we were enemies, we were reconciled to God through the death of his Son, how much more, once reconciled, will we be saved by his life? Not only that, but we also boast of God through our Lord Jesus Christ, through whom we have now received reconciliation. The word of the Lord.
Sisters and brothers, the Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. When Jesus saw the crowds, he went up the mountainside, and after he had sat down, his disciples gathered around him, and he began to teach them. How blessed are the poor in spirit, The reign of God is theirs. Blessed too are those who mourn, for they will be consoled. Blessed are the lowly, for they will inherit the land. Blessed are they who hunger and thirst for holiness, for they shall have their fill. Blessed are they who show mercy. Mercy shall be theirs. Blessed are the single-hearted, for they shall see God. Blessed too the peacemakers. They will be called sons of God. Blessed are those persecuted for holiness' sake. The reign of God is theirs. Blessed are you when they insult you and persecute you and utter every kind of evil against you falsely because of me. Be glad and rejoice, for your reward in heaven is great. The Gospel of the Lord. I'd like to welcome you all here to St. Paul Parish to pray for Bill. And what a beautiful tribute it is to Bill and his family that so many of you are here on a summer's day to support them in their sorrow, support them with your prayers. And on your behalf and on behalf of our parish, I want to extend to Bill's family our sincerest condolences, to Bill's father, the Honorable Edward Harrington, to his wife, Jeanette, to his children, Billy, Jacqueline, and Grady, his brother, to John, and his wife, Joanne, Mary, and her husband, Jim, Catherine, and her husband, Jim, Elizabeth and her husband John, Edward and his wife Sarah, and then Bill was brother-in-law to Jeannie and Kenneth, and to his 22 nieces and nephews. And also this, to friends. I know Bill was blessed with many, many friends. You're certainly among them. Make particular note of his softball team. Doing what they do, form a special bond. And the loss of Bill is felt as deeply for him, by you, as for a family member. So to all of you, we extend our sincerest condolences and hope that our prayers here today and our faith in Jesus might be a comfort as we entrust Bill to the Lord's care. There are different ways to experience life in this world. One way is as a tourist or simply a spectator. The tourist or spectator appreciates the beauty and wonder of life in this world, but sees it and observes it at a distance, as if riding through life on a tour bus. Another way to experience life in this world is participation. The participant is fully immersed in and engages the bounty that life in this world offers. Clearly, Bill Harrington was not a tourist, he was a participant. Indeed, he died participating. Softball, hiking, boating, snowshoeing, cross-country skiing, many other things. Bill participated. As a fully engaged participant in this life, Bill was interested in you with his insatiable curiosity about people. I suspect that is extremely important for a lawyer to be interested in the lives of his clients, not just the data. And certainly being interested, insatiably curious, makes for great friendships, of which Bill had many. Of course, more important than all of these is Bill's participation in the life of his family. His best friend, Jeanette, his wife of 26 years, his kids, Billy, Jacqueline, and Grady, his father, the Honorable Judge, his siblings and their spouses, his 22 nieces and nephews. That participant love, which involved Bill fully in the life of his family, is what makes this day so deeply painful. On the other hand, our hope today lies in participant love, God's participant love, God's deep desire to participate in love with us. That God so loved the world that he gave us his only Son, Jesus. Jesus, the Son of God, fully immersed in every dimension of our lives, fully immersed in every dimension of humanity. Jesus, fully human and fully divine, intimately participates in every aspect of our lives, even to the point of death, giving his life for those he loves. Jesus is the ultimate statement of God's desire for us, God's desire to participate fully in our lives, to have this intimate relationship with us. Through baptism, we have that intimate relationship. We have the very life of God pulsating in us. In baptism, we fully participate in the life of Jesus. For in baptism, we die with Jesus. And in baptism, we share intimately in his resurrection from the dead. Bill Harrington, as you know so well, was an extremely gifted man, intellectually, professionally, interpersonally, yet he remained modest and humble, invoking that first beatitude with which we're so familiar, blessed are the poor in spirit, meaning blessed are the humble. Today, at the conclusion of Bill's tragically brief but extraordinary life, we celebrate Jesus, who humbled himself to share in our humanity. Jesus' loving participation in our lives, even unto death, is our salvation. There is no other name by which we are saved. And Jesus is the reason we have such great hope for Billy today, despite the depth of our sorrow. Bill's death is extremely painful for all of you. Perhaps the worst sorrow many of you have ever felt in your life. But we are confident that Bill lives, for he has died with Christ. Whoever dies with Christ lives with Christ. Christ is risen from the dead. Alleluia, alleluia. So having heard God's word, we now stand to offer our petitions and our sister Catherine, Kate, Beth, Mary, Jeannie, Grady, Julie, and Lily to lead us in our petitions before the Lord.
Our response to our prayers is, Lord, hear our prayer. In baptism, Bill received the life of Christ. May we, Bill, rejoice in eternal rest. And may we, who mourn his death, passing life with hope in the promise of everlasting life, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Bill's family, especially our dad, siblings, cousins, in-laws, and many nieces and nephews, that they may be inspired by Bill's example of devotion and service to his loved ones. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Bill's children, Billy, Jackie, and Grady, that they may feel their dad's incalculable love for them, surrounding them each and every day. May they bear witness to his life and values through the ways in which they live their lives. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Bill's beloved wife and the love of his life, Jeanette, that she may feel Bill's calm and steady presence as she walks with strength in the days ahead, knowing that she has a community that loves and supports her always. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for members of Bill's family who predeceased him, especially Bill's mother, Ellen, and Jeanette's mother, Janice, that they may welcome him into the company of all the saints. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray that we may live as my dad lived, with integrity, humility, and a sense of humor, that we may care for those on the margins and support our servicemen and women, veterans and first responders, especially family members Billy Pershing, Jack Carroll, Daniel Harrington, and Mike Murphy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for Bill's friends from the Hummocks, West Roxbury, Needham, Boston College, Hingham, and beyond, that we may cherish the memories shared with Bill and strive to be the type of man and friend he was. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for the personal intentions we hold in the silence of our hearts, that our Lord may hear and answer them. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. Good and loving God, though our hearts are sorrowful, but at the same time full of hope, for you have raised Jesus from the dead, we entrust Bill to your care. We pray to you in the name of the one whom you have sent, Jesus, who is Lord forever and ever. Amen. If you please be seated. Now, as we're about to celebrate the Eucharist, we ask Mark Harrington, Mary Beth Garahan, Sarah Harrington, and Aidan Power to bring forward our gifts of bread and wine. So please pray, my sisters and brothers, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. As we humbly present to you these sacrificial offerings, O Lord, for the salvation of your servant Bill, we beseech your mercy that Bill, who did not doubt your Son to be a loving Savior, may find in him a merciful judge who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
And let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. In him the hope of blessed resurrection has dawned, that those saddened by the certainty of dying might be consoled by the promise of immortality to come. Indeed, for your faithful Lord, life is changed, not ended. And when this earthly dwelling turns to dust, an eternal dwelling is made ready for them in heaven. And so, with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory, as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna, Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, and all you have created rightly gives you praise. For through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, by the power and working of the Holy Spirit, you give life to all things and make them holy. And you never cease to gather a people to yourself, so that from the rising of the sun to its setting, a pure sacrifice may be offered to your name. Therefore, O Lord, we humbly implore you, by the same Spirit, graciously make holy these gifts we have brought to you for consecration, that they may become the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ, at whose command we celebrate these mysteries. From the night he was betrayed, Jesus took bread, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, broke the bread, and gave it to a disciple, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, Jesus took the chalice, and giving you thanks, he said the blessing, and gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, celebrate the memorial of the saving passion of your Son, his wondrous resurrection and ascension into heaven. As we look forward to his second coming, we offer you in thanksgiving this holy and living sacrifice. Look, we pray, upon the oblation of your church, and recognize in the sacrificial victim by whose death you will to reconcile us to yourself. Grant that we, who are nourished by the body and blood of your Son, and filled with his Holy Spirit, may become one body, one spirit in Christ. May he make of us an eternal offering to you, so we may obtain an inheritance with your elect, especially with the most blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with blessed Joseph, her spouse, with your blessed apostles and glorious martyrs, with Saint Paul, and with all the saints, on whose constant intercession in your presence we rely for unfailing help. May this sacrifice of our reconciliation, we pray, O Lord, advance the peace and salvation of all the world. Be pleased to confirm in faith and charity your pilgrim church on earth, with your servant Francis, our Pope, and Sean, our Bishop, the order of bishops, all the clergy, and the entire people you have gained for your own. Listen graciously to the prayers of this family whom you have summoned before you. In your compassion, O merciful Father, gather to yourself all your children scattered throughout the world. Remember your servant Bill, whom you have called from this world to yourself. Grant that Bill, who is united with your Son in a death like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection, when from the earth he will raise up in the flesh those who have died and transform our lowly body after the pattern of his own glorious body. To our departed brothers and sisters too, and to all who are pleasing to you at their passing from this life, give kind admittance to your kingdom. There we hope to enjoy forever the fullness of your glory, when you will wipe away every tear from our eyes. For seeing you, our God, as you are, we shall become like you for all the ages and praise you without end, through Christ our Lord, through whom you bestow on the world all that is good. Through him and with him and in him, O God, almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom and the power and the glory are yours, now and forever. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you, look not on our sins but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. The peace of the Lord be with you always. Now let's offer one another a sign of the Lord's peace.
God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please kneel. Please kneel or sit as you are able. In a moment, those Catholics who are spiritually prepared to receive Holy Communion will be invited to come forward. Those who are not receiving Holy Communion are welcome to be seated and offer a prayer for Bill. If you're not receiving Holy Communion, but would like a blessing, you're certainly welcome to come up to me and indicate such by placing your hands on your shoulders like so, and that will be an indication to me that you'd like a blessing, and I'd be very honored to give you a blessing. We come to Holy Communion by way of the center aisle, so the folks in the wings, if you'd follow the corresponding the group of folks opposite you to Holy Communion, that would be very helpful. And we return by way of the side aisles. Thank you. And there'll be six of us distributing Holy Communion across here, so please use the six of us. Thank you.
Please join in our communion song, number 527, Prayer of Saint Francis. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope.
darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console, to be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving of ourselves that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Please join in singing number 437, On Eagle's Wings. You who dwell in the shelter of the Lord, who abide in his shadow for life, say to the Lord, my refuge, my rock, in whom I trust, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. The snare of the fowler will never capture you, and famine will bring you no fear. Under his wings, your refuge, his faithfulness, your shield, and he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. You need not fear the terror of the night, nor the arrow that flies by day, though thousands fall about you, near you it shall not come, and he will raise you up.
upon eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. For to his angels he's given a command to guard you in all of your ways. Upon their hands they will bear you up, lest you dash your foot against a stone. And he will raise you up on eagle's wings, bear you on the breath of dawn, make you to shine like the sun, and hold you in the palm of his hand. And hold you in the palm of his hand.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us in the sacrament of his body food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Bill may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Would you please be seated? And now, to remember Bill, we ask his brother Ted and his son Billy to come forward to offer words of remembrance.
Billy, Uncle Bill. He had it all figured out. He was a lot like his mom. A quiet determination, a peacemaker, held no grudges, no ego, no boasting, never took himself too seriously, even keeled, unflappable, decent, loyal, smart, a true gentleman. Although Billy's my younger brother, like most of you here, I was in awe and humbled by his ability and his character. Billy was late in speaking as a child. I think today he would have been seen by some specialists, but he had it figured out. First, he probably couldn't get a word in. He simply observed his five older siblings and his parents. He just watched and he listened. Billy was also a bit slow in moving. As a kid, my mom said he had two speeds, slow and slower. Although not born with great speed, he was strong and he was tough. And I can attest, if you pushed him too far, he would make his presence known. But it took a lot to get Billy upset. Only very special people could do it. My mom would say the best way to judge a person's character was to look at their friends. And looking around this church, my mom, like Bill, had it figured out. People of substance and character and good humor are those he chose to live his life with and who chose to be his friends. There's certainly no higher achievement. Billy loved his friends from St. Joe's, Needham High, Boston College, Suffolk Law, all the people he met professionally and here in the town of Hingham. People loved Billy because of his authenticity. He was real. He never changed, and that was his charm. Billy excelled as a lawyer. He was always a great advocate for his clients, but more importantly, he thrived without resorting to any gamesmanship. Billy did not have to. He was brilliant and he was honest, and that's always a tough combo to beat, especially when people mistook his decency for a weakness. His true brilliance was his simplicity. He had no time for gossip or drama or complaints. He just went about his business. And he was truly interested in your lives and your kids. He'd show up to countless games for his nieces and nephews, not because of obligation, but he really enjoyed going to games and having a good time. Billy had figured out the balances of life. And he was a very content man. He was not without his quirks. He was not afraid to be a big kid. How many 50-year-olds bring a mitt to Fenway Park? And chase down foul balls with the fervor of a 12-year-old. Billy loved a bargain. Again, like my mom. I purchased this tie from Kohl's yesterday in his honor. It was a 2-for-1. My son Joey reminded me of a great story when we were golfing last spring. Billy was bragging about his new golf clubs. Bill's definition of new were these old clubs he had bought at a yard sale that had Sam Snead and Bobby Jones engraved on them, and included an old woman's wooden club. He still banked it down the middle. He had it figured out. His greatest success was his family, a loving marriage, each complementing each other's strengths, a marriage based on love and respect, and yes, a sense of humor. Jeanette, you brought out the best in Billy. With you, his true personality came out. To skiing, mountain climbing, boating, kayaking, snowshoeing. Yes, Billy Harrington had become an adventurous outdoorsman. Only true love could do that. You also brought out his loving side, and it was great to see, and we all thank you for that. Three beautiful and accomplished children. Like all parents, Billy loved to speak of his children's accomplishments. Billy, your dad was so proud of your intelligence and equally so with your independent thinking. He loved you so much and was so proud of the great young man you have become. Jackie, I think I speak for most. Thank God you went to Holy Cross. You kept Gramps going these past few years, and your dad was so proud. He was your biggest fan. Cross-country fit, your dad's idea of a good spectator sport. See the runners into the woods and have time for a sandwich and a beer. He loved you and was so proud of the beautiful young woman that you've become. Grady, the baby, your dad bragged of your football heroics and your blue-collar ice hockey play. He was awed by your toughness and your kind character and by the great young man you were becoming. I know that I and many others will become fans of Saints football. One of Bill's old favorites, Elvis Costello, rhetorically asked in song, "What's so funny about peace, love, and understanding?" Bill certainly understood. He had to figure it out. You can't thank a man for 1,000 memories or 1,000 laughs. Bill made us all better for having had the privilege to have known him. In his honor, I will strive to live more like Billy. The world would certainly be a better place if it had more like Billy Harrington in it.
It was only recently, really in the last year since I graduated, that I began to realize what a special person my father was. Like all children of good parents, I took them for granted. I'm sure I still do. But my father was special, not because of his impressive professional accomplishments, nor because of his admittedly less impressive athletic accomplishments. My father was special because of how he supported the people he cared about. He was special because of how curious he was about their lives, and because of how humble and honest and genuine he was throughout his own. My father managed to achieve what so many strive for, a successful, rewarding career in a field in which he excelled, and a rich family life with loving, supportive relationships with his wife and each of his three children. He lived a full life, and he earned it. I think he was the most hardworking person I've ever met. I have memories from as far back as I can remember of him working away, buried underneath reams of paper at the living room coffee table or in his little nook in the corner of the basement. If I ever needed him, whether it was early in the morning or late at night, I had only to follow a trail of paper and highlighter caps. But if I ever needed him, he was there. He made sure of it. He used the freedom that a private practice afforded him to set his own hours and to be involved in every aspect of our lives. He rarely missed dinner and never missed a youth sports game. He was our biggest fan, both on and off the field. He went to everything, games, meets, regattas, recitals, and robotics competitions. He went to accepted students' days and graduations. He visited you at your job to embarrass you in front of your coworkers. He showed up in a U-Haul to help you move apartments. He was always there because he always wanted to be. My dad possessed the endearing combination of an open mind and an acute interest in people. He cared far less about what he was doing than who he was doing it with. He climbed mountains and skied down them. He crossed oceans and raised pets. He spent weekends at cross-country meets and marathoning Lord of the Rings, all because the people he cared about were interested in doing so. He was the easiest person in the world to be friends with, because his interests were your interests, as simple as that. He loved to hike and loved to ski. He loved to travel and he loved the dogs. He loved track and field and he loved Samwise Gamgee. It's not that he pretended to care about your interests just so he could spend time with you. He cared about those interests because of the time it allowed him to spend with you. And he asked questions constantly. I've met toddlers less inquisitive. He was especially curious about the lives of his family. He wanted a full stat breakdown of every game he couldn't personally attend. He wanted a full attendance of every gathering of our friends. He wanted to know exactly how much Jackie made in tips each day. He wanted to know if I was in a good sleep routine. He wanted to know what shows we were watching. He wanted to know what we thought about history and politics, school and work. He wanted to know about our hobbies, our goals for the future, and the lives of our friends. This curiosity served him well outside of the interrogation of his children. He was very good at what he did, although you would never have known it from talking to him. He refused to take himself too seriously, or even seriously at all. He had a goofy, mischievous sense of humor and an infectious laugh. He had an unshakable optimism and a quiet self-confidence. He made friends quickly, and he kept them for life. So many of these friends are here today, including his best friend, my mother. In the last year or so, I was lucky enough to experience an evolution in my relationship with my father. I felt like I was starting to get to know him all over again, as someone more than just my father, but as a human being and as a friend. And if there's any silver lining to this past week, it has been that so many people who knew my dad in so many different ways have been sharing their stories of him. And each of these stories is a little piece of my father. In listening to each of them, I'm able to form a more complete picture of the wonderful man that he was. I love you, Dad. I'll miss you.
Friends, on behalf of Bill's family, we'd like to extend a special thank you to all of you who were able to join us here this morning. We're sincerely grateful for both your presence and your continued support. We'd also like to extend a special thank you to St. Paul Parish, Father Nestor, the parish staff, Hingham Police Department, as well as Brookline Police Department. To our readers, our ushers, our pallbearers, and our eulogists, we thank you. A friend of mine always says that the greatest gift that we can give to a family in need is the gift of presence. So for all of you who played a silent part leading up to today, we thank you as well. Immediately following today's funeral mass, everyone in attendance is invited to join the family at the Red Lion Inn, located at 71 South Main Street in Cohasset. In just a few moments, we'll be leaving church as a group. As we exit the church, you'll be invited to take a flower. The flower is a physical symbol of your love and Bill's love that stayed together forever. As you exit the church, the hearse door will be open. You'll be invited to place the flower inside the hearse with Bill. It'll stay with him for cremation. Just like your love continues, it stays with him. We ask that you say a brief goodbye to the family at the front door, being mindful that St. Paul's School has an early release, and all relatives and friends in attendance to please return to their cars after leaving the church to make the dismissal process a seamless experience for both parents and children. Thank you.
So we stand now to conclude our prayers for Bill. Trusting in God, we have prayed together for Bill, and now we come to the last farewell. There is sadness in parting, but we take comfort in the hope that one day we shall see Bill again and enjoy his friendship. Although this congregation will disperse in sorrow, the mercy of God will gather us together again in the joy of his kingdom. Therefore, let us console one another in the faith of Jesus Christ.
O loving God, we send your Son home to you, home to a place of everlasting love, to join there with the angel choirs and blessed saints, and to behold your glorious holy face. Receive his song and let eternal light shine. Eternal light forever on his soul, so he may be forever in your dwelling place, and be at rest in peace until we meet him there.
Into your hands, Father of Mercies, we commend Bill in the sure and certain hope that together with all who have died in Christ, Bill will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessings you bestowed upon Bill in this life. They are signs to us of your goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to Bill and help us who remain to comfort one another with assurances of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with Bill forever. We ask this through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. May the angels lead you into paradise. May the martyrs come to welcome you and take you to the holy city, the new and eternal Jerusalem. May choirs of angels welcome you and lead you to the bosom of Abraham. And where Lazarus is poor no longer, may you find eternal rest.
Please join in singing number 433, Amazing Grace.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear the hour I first believed. Lord, my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be as long as life endures. Through many dangers, toils, and snares, I have already come. 'Tis grace has brought me safe thus far, and grace will lead me home. When we've met there 10,000 years, bright shining as the sun, we've no less days to sing God's praise than when we'd first begun.